Hi, I'm Elizabeth Hall with Smart Office Help Social Media Management. Today I'm going to show you how to pin an image from your computer and connect it to a URL on the web. It's very easy. Now, before we get started, I just want to say if you'd like to receive updates on more social media tips and videos, please subscribe and also rate this video at the end. Okay. Pinterest is a very good way to refer traffic back to your website. And most businesses don't use this referral traffic, but you can use it to actually refer traffic back to your blog by using images. And you can pick those images right up off of your computer and then connect it to a particular blog post. I'm going to show you how to do that today. If you haven't already done so, you can set up a Pinterest business account separate from your personal one, which I always suggest. Some people already have established personal accounts and they like to use those, but I would suggest to use a separate one, and that way you can really tailor your pins to reflect your business message or your objectives and goals. Let's get started. Once you have your account set up, and I have one set up here for Smart Office Help Social Media Management, and this is a new account. You won't see a lot of pins on here because we're in the process of connecting pins to our website. Always remember that your social media should be a work in progress. So let's get started here. All right. First, you're going to go to your pin. So if you go here and you click on the name for your business or for yourself, once you're logged in, you go to your pins. Now that we're in the pins, you'll see that there are six tabs across the board here. You have Get Started, you have Boards, Pins, Likes, Followers, and Following. And then you'll see here a list of pins because this is where we're at. Pins. Now, before we go into how to pick up that pin, you'll see that I have three boards here already created. Let's go into this one where it says social media tutorials. You'll see that I have two pins here for social media tutorials, and these are actually videos from the YouTube account. I only connected two, but more will be posted shortly. You can edit the board or you can add pins. Let's go back to our boards. We're gonna go to our boards and we're going to actually work on social media tips blog. So here we have one pin in this particular board. Now to create a board is pretty easy. Let's go back. I'll show you how to create a board real quick. Let's go to my pins and we'll go to boards. Okay, you can create a board here. So you go to create board and it's very self-explanatory. You have your name, description, and category. Now you always want to make sure that you can pick the correct category or as close to it as you can, which is pretty difficult if you have something that is in a very specific niche. All right, you put the name for your board here, and then you'll put your description. Now, it's important to know for SEO purposes, you always want to try to use hashtags for searchability, but hashtags will not work in the description here or in the name. So you can put it there for visibility, but it is not searchable. You can make the board secret or not. And then you would just say create the board and it will create. So I've created the three boards here. We're going to work specifically in the social media tips blog because we've already created that board. So we'll add a pin. And we're going to add the pin from my computer. And it'll ask you upload an image right from your computer. Choose the image. And we'll go to... I have a folder for pins. block pens. And we're gonna go to, I have a PNG made for one of my blogging posts, and the size of it is 225 by 150 pixels. You'll have to experiment on the best dimensions that will show for your pens. So we'll open that. And here you can put a description, and we'll put why it's okay to follow your followers. And here, the hashtags are actually searchable. So we are going to put in a couple of hashtags, social media tips, crazy social media tips. And you can also put in websites. So I'm going to put in smartofficehelp.com. How about just stick in also my Twitter handle? And then we'll say pin. You'll see here that the pin has been uploaded, but we're not done with this pin just yet. We've only pulled it from the computer, but it's not connected to a website. So here you'll see a little pencil, and that means you can edit this. So let's edit. And here you can add more to the description if you like. And where it says source, this is where you want to put your URL for this specific image to go to the specific blog post. Now I have that. I have some short codes here. So let's just pick up this short code. And say save changes. Now you have your pin here. As you can see, you can actually click on the hashtags and these will come up. Let's just go back in here because let's see if we put the www in. Should be able to. Yeah. Okay. So that's saved. So let's actually click on that image. And this is what comes up. This is what a follower will see on the image when they click on it. They have a couple of options. They can pin it, they can like it, they can go to the website. And the website is actually the source that you connected to the image. They can send it. And here you'll see we have the website and the hashtags are searchable. Now let's just click it and see what happens. If you click directly onto the image, it will now go to the website and it goes to the blog post. 5 reasons why it's okay to follow your followers on Twitter. Fantastic. Let's go back. If you click here where it says website, it will go to that blog post. And that's how you connect your URL to an image. And that will help create visibility for your blog. And you'll see these are the only 2 that are posted here. And that's it for today. That's how you pin an image from your computer and connect a specific URL. If you have any social media related questions, please leave those in the comments and I will answer those on a future video or on a future podcast. Thanks again for watching. Please subscribe for future updates. Don't forget to rate this video at the end. Now go out and grow your networks using social media. Have a great day.